More than 5 million Americans are living with Alzheimer's, and more than 15 million caregivers provide care to those who have the disease. Because caring for someone with Alzheimer's is such a difficult task, I talked with one woman who did just that for over 10 years.
Mike Riley just turned 75.
You remembered your birthday yesterday?
But he doesn't remember.
Your birthday yesterday?
It was?
It was your birthday yesterday.
Riley can't remember his birthday because he's been battling Alzheimer's for 14 years now.
How old are we?
Until you take care of yourself.
I don't know.
Riley's wife, Nancy, was the first person to notice early signs of Alzheimer's in her husband.
He would forget where his billfold was. He would forget where his keys were.
Those early signs.
His activity level changed. He loved golf, and he didn't want to play golf anymore.
Turned into more noticeable lifestyle changes.
He loved social activity, and he slowly didn't want to go anywhere.
Nancy took care of her husband by herself up until almost 1 year ago.
It was honestly just wearing me down. Yeah, it was tough. So, and then I would keep telling myself, no, I can do this, I can do this. But I finally just couldn't anymore.
Nancy's son, Steve, comes to visit his mom as much as possible. He says he knew how much it took out of her to care for his dad all of those years.
I don't know how mom did it as long as she did it. The key was that we wanted her to communicate with us as to when it was getting to the point where something needed to be done.
In the end, Nancy did let her sons know when she thought it was time.
But you can slowly see their life just kind of slowing down, and you have to come to grips with what's coming.
Alex Barton is with the Alzheimer's Association. She says she's used to seeing families and caregivers, like Nancy, pushing themselves to care for their loved ones.
Their health is impacted maybe because they're not taking care of their health themselves, seeing the doctor, that type of thing, and the stress and the burden that is placed on a caregiver when they're having a job that is day in and day out.
Now Nancy is able to get a break at home, but she still considers herself a caregiver.
Even though he's in a facility does not mean you're not a caregiver, because you still go up and take care.
The Alzheimer's Association in Dubuque has support groups that those caring for someone with the disease can attend. Nancy and Alex both say these groups are a great way to get connected with those who are going through a similar situation.
Yeah, single-handedly even caring for someone with Alzheimer's for over 10 years.
Yeah,
that's incredible.
It's a lot, and as Nancy said, you know, it just got too much, and some people can live with Alzheimer's for up to 20 years. So,
thanks for the story, Allison. Mm-hmm.